Hey everyone, I'm Ruth. Welcome back to another video. In this tutorial, I'm painting poppies with watercolors. I'll show you all my painting techniques, so let's get right into the tutorial. I start by taping my paper to the surface, and then I randomly apply some diluted paint onto my paper and blow it in various directions with a drinking straw. And I apply some greens, reds, and blow it away with the drinking straw again. And when that layer has dried, I use my mechanical pencil to draw a light pencil sketch of some poppies, and I make sure that I use a very light hand to draw this sketch so the pencil won't show through my painting later on. And when I am happy with my pencil sketch, I go in with my paint again, and now the paint is not so diluted anymore. It's much thicker than my first layer. And I paint around the pencil sketch, so around the flower shapes, to make the flowers appear. And I use plain water to dilute the paint a little bit on my paper when I think that it's too dark. And I use the drinking straw again to blow away the paint to create that fun splashy effect. I use my black velvet silver brush number 8 for this painting, and arch hot pressed watercolor paper to paint on. So another layer of darker paint, thicker paint, when the previous layer has dried. I let these layers dry in between, and then I go over it with even darker paint to make the flower stand out. Painting around the flower shape again with various green shades, and then using the drinking straw to blow it away. And of course, you don't have to choose the same colors as I have chosen. You can use any colors you like. I use the tip of my brush to paint around the shape of the flower, because you can paint very precisely with this tip of this brush, of the black velvet silver brush. That's why I like this brush so much. With the tip you can paint very precisely, and then with the side of the brush you can paint bigger shapes very easily. Now I add some color to the flowers itself, some shadow to define the petals of the flowers and to make the petals stand out. And I go over to the next flower, and as you can see, by adding this dark green color, I define the flower and I define the petals. And this is what's called negative painting. By painting around the shapes of the flowers, you make the flowers stand out, make them appear. And I use a smaller brush now, because I want to be really precise here to define these flowers. And as you can see, with each layer I use darker paint, so thicker paint, diluted some more with water on the paper, and then I blow it away with my drinking straw. So I add thick paint, then some more diluted paint, and then I blow it away with my drinking straw to create that fun effect. And I repeat this process on each section of my painting. And this way I make the flowers and the flower buds stand out. And I do the same on the inside of the flowers, defining the petals by painting around the shapes. And this way I create the petals and the flower shapes. And I let the paint dry in between each layer. I wait until the paper is completely dry before I add another layer. And I do this to prevent the paint from running out. So here I'm adding some more color to the inside of the flowers to define the petals some more. And then I'm ready to take off the tape. Thank you very much for watching my video. If you liked it, please give me a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Hit the notification bell to get informed when a new video comes out. You can leave a comment down below and don't forget to share my video with all your friends. You can also follow me on Facebook and Instagram. Thank you! Bye!